Hello, and welcome back to my series on learning commands in Minecraft. My name is slicedlime, and today we're going to start learning about the surprisingly useful concept of scoreboards. At first glance, the concept of a scoreboard seems a rather simple thing. A list of names in order, and a score for each one, right? That's pretty much what a scoreboard is in Minecraft as well, but a few additional functions make it much more useful than you'd think. So let's start with the basics. You can have any number of scoreboards in Minecraft. Strictly speaking, each separate board is called a scoreboard objective, but everyone just calls them scoreboards, so that's the term we're going to use here too. The command we'll be using is unsurprisingly called scoreboard. Like some of the other powerful commands we'll be going through lately, the scoreboard command has many subcommands, and we'll be learning only the basic ones this time. To begin with, the first subcommand we need is scoreboard objectives, which is used to manage the scoreboard objectives themselves. By default, the game has no scoreboards at all. We need to add them to be able to start using scoreboards. We do that with the scoreboard objectives add sub command. This needs a scoreboard name, which is sort of an ID. Compared to other IDs we've seen, these ones are not namespaced, so there's no Minecraft colon or such in them. So let's use pigginess as our name here for a test. Scoreboard objectives add pigginess dummy. No, I'm not calling you a dummy. That's an actual parameter. The argument after the name is the scoreboard type. There are a lot of types related to many different things in the game, but one of the most common types is the dummy type. Dummy scoreboards never get updated by the game itself, it's only changed by commands. There's one more optional argument, the display name. You can think of this as the title of the scoreboard. It's what shows up when the scoreboard is referenced in messages, and it's what shows up when the scoreboard displays on the screen. Because this is a display string, it's something called a component. Text components are a whole topic of their own we'll get to in a later episode, but luckily this one is optional, so for now, we'll just leave it out. And just like that, we've created our first scoreboard. Nothing is visible, and nothing seems to have changed though, so this far, it's not very useful. How do we see what's in the scoreboard? Let's display it. That is done with another scoreboard objectives sub command. The scoreboard objectives set display one. There are a number of options available for scoreboard display, but we'll start with the most useful one now, sidebar. The sidebar display shows up on the right side of the screen and is always visible. So to activate the sidebar display for our pigginess scoreboard, we run scoreboard objectives set display sidebar pigginess. There we go, or not, because nothing showed up. Why? Because the scoreboard is empty, so there's nothing to display. So we need to give something a score. That gets us into the second scoreboard subcommand, scoreboard players. This too has subcommands. Let's use a simple one first. Scoreboard players set at s pigginess 1. Seems rather clear from just reading it out like that. Set the score of the player at s, which we learned last time is the entity executing the command, that is myself. The scoreboard to set the score in is the pigginess scoreboard, and the value to set is 1. And there we go, my pigginess level is now 1, and the scoreboard is showing up on the right side of the screen. Fantastic! It's not much of an interest as a scoreboard unless it's a competition though, is it? What chance do I have in a competition against Piggo though? This also exposes that the scoreboard players subcommand is misnamed. It's not actually restricted to players at all, you can add a score for any entity. So let's do scoreboard players set at e type equals pig, tag equals Piggo, pigginess 9000. Yep. So Piggo beats me handedly. But his scoreboard entry doesn't show his name, it shows his UUID. All non-player entities are stored in scoreboards as their UUID. That means they'll always match exactly even if there are multiple entities with the same name, but also means the display is harder to read. It actually goes further than that. You can put other things than entities and players on the scoreboard. But what else is there though? Entities and players cover a lot of what there is in Minecraft. The answer is you fake it. Just make something up, and you can put it on the scoreboard. So I can do scoreboard players set the god of pigs, pigginess 2 billion. Clearly, the god of pigs isn't a player in this world, yet it shows up. That is known as a fake player and illustrates how pretty much any name is also allowed on the scoreboard. So what else can we do with the scoreboard? This far it doesn't seem too useful. One of the most obvious things to do with a scoreboard is to count scores up and down. We do that using the add and remove sub-subcommands of scoreboard players. Scoreboard players add at e type equals pig, tag equals pigo, pig in s5. Scoreboard players remove at s, pig in s1. As you can see, having a score of 0 is different from not having a score at all. To make an entry of the scoreboard disappear entirely, we can use the scoreboard players reset sub-command. Scoreboard players reset at s, pig in s. That makes me vanish entirely from the scoreboard. One more thing to know is that adding or removing a score from someone who doesn't already have a score acts as if that name had a score of 0. This is sometimes useful if you want to make sure some entity has a score in the scoreboard, but you don't want to change that score if it does. Just add 0 to its score. So, the god of pigs now has a pretty high score, but there are limits. The allowed values in a scoreboard entry are between negative 2,147,483,648 and 2,147,483,647 positive. Usually not something you have to worry about, but there are cases where it matters. One more thing to know is that adding 1 when you're already at the limit is still a valid command. It makes the score wrap around all the way to the bottom instead. There's much more to say yet, but before we get into that, please take a moment to add 1 to the like score for this video. That really helps out get these videos shared across YouTube, so I'd really appreciate it. Thanks! If you forgot what scoreboards you made, maybe because you came back to a project after pausing it for a while, or you're looking at somebody else's custom map, then there's a command to list them all. That's scoreboard objectives list. There's one more scoreboard objectives sub-command, and that is to remove a scoreboard. Scoreboard objectives remove pigginess. That would, of course, remove the scoreboard from display, remove all the scores in it, and remove the scoreboard itself. Let's not do that now, though. We have more things to go through, so let's keep the scoreboard. So, we know how to display scores, set scores, and add points to them. That's great if we're making a game with scores, but not so much otherwise. So why did I start this video saying they were so useful? That is because you can also use scoreboards in selectors using the scores selector argument. This one is a bit more complicated than the previous ones we've seen. Let's try it out using our scoreboard. Say, at e, scores equals open brace, pigginess equals 9000, end brace. Let's unpack that. The scores selector argument is always followed by open and close braces. The contents of this block is one or more scoreboard requirements. In this case, we selected nothing, because Pigo's score was over 9000. Luckily, the score requirements are not single values. Just like with the distance selector argument before, they're ranges, so we can instead do, say at e, scores equals pigginess equals 9000 or more. There we go. We selected Pigo because of his high level of pigginess. If you have multiple scoreboards, you can also have several criteria in one. So let's add another one. Scoreboard objectives add awesomeness dummy. And scoreboard players set at e type equals pig, tag equals pigo, awesomeness 69. Let's see how it looks if we want to select based on both these criteria. Say at e, scores equals pigginess equals 9000 or more, comma, awesomeness equals 69. So if we have more scores to check, we separate them by commas. We can also see here that we didn't need to show the scoreboard, we could use the scores in the awesomeness scoreboard without the player ever seeing it. Of course, we can also combine score selection with other selector arguments, so let's say we want to select only the pigs with those scores, that'd become, say, at e, type equals pig, scores equals pigginess 9000 or more, awesomeness 69. Before we wrap up here, let me also mention how to get rid of this sidebar that's seemingly stuck to the side of my face. You do that by running the scoreboard objective set display command again, but not giving it any scoreboard. That removes whatever display is on there at the moment. And that is enough for this time. My name is slicedlime, thank you for learning commands with me. Make sure to download the companion map and do the exercises there to get some hands-on practice, and feel free to join my Discord where we have a channel for learning commands. See you next time!